Touch it. That one. Oh, okay. Teamwork makes the dream work. Hi, I'm your favorite Soul One and your Flame, here to bring you another tour video. Starring Stealth and Deranged. Right now, I am spectating Stealth. Watch what he does and I'll explain later. Alright, so that's how it goes. Now, I'll explain what's happening here, but more in slow motion. So at the very start, he runs to the objective, because that's where he is focused at. He grabs the objective immediately, without hesitation, and throws a flash, bouncing it off that wood piece, allowing for anyone who turns the corner to be flashed. And Deranged throws a flash himself, which you'll see later. So, Stealth takes the lead because he isn't the one throwing the flash. That is the other guy that allows us to actually be in a lobby. So, that's why I didn't shoot him. But anyways, he continues forward without hesitation. And if there's any snipers, I think he may obviously shoot them down. But other than that, he keeps trekking on. And no one knows. No one knows at all, because he's surpassed the layer of defense of where the enemies are usually at anyways. But you see how he got flashed like that? And he kept going? It might have been Deranged's mistake, but that's something that we need. We need players to be able to be flashed, but still know where they're going. So that's something you could work on too as well. Alright. Now the next clip I fake will be the Deranged's side. And I'll show you. So I'm spectating Deranged right now. And I'll make sure to slow down the clip next time, so that I'm able to go over more details, because there's a little more that goes on with the Deranged's side than it is Stealth side, because all he needs to do is charge. He throws a flash and charge, but the main part is actually watching his back here, as you can see. So I'll go to explain that. Okay, so at the very beginning, he flanks the east side so that he can get to the east window, the upper bank that is, much quicker. Stealth is running towards the objective, and he's already this close to the upper bank window. Not to mention that Stealth can throw a flash and flash the enemy side of the lower bank. This allows for more time being bought while he's shooting down players, as well as the range. So you see how he throws that flash? That's very perfect flash, and that'll get people 90% of the time. But none if they're not in the bank at the moment. They'll run in. So he allows Stealth to charge in because he didn't throw the flash at it. Allowing Stealth to go first means he's got lead. And the range pretends to shoot down the enemy while Stealth keeps going forward. But notice how he's running and watching Stealth's back. This is something that needs to happen all the time, because some people might catch notice as to what it is stealth is doing. It throws that flash, got you pretty far. It flashes stealth. It's amazing. But anyways, he follows stealth and doesn't bother going through the window upstairs, just to shoot down whoever goes after stealth. Which is the main point about him being behind stealth, is to watch his back and throw flashes. And all stealth does is charges in. That's all he has to do. Other than maybe shoot down one or two players. Or maybe stealth can handle all the players. So long as stealth doesn't get caught, then the range doesn't have to worry about anything. And that is the main assessment of what's going on right here. More talk on it. This clip represents the speed of which stealth and the range is pushing. And that was well done. Now for the next clip, the more slowed part, so I can explain. So I'm following stealth, and this is what stealth does. This should explain how fast it is that he's doing. The swiftness is kind of amazing, and I've never seen anything like it before. In all of my experience in the game, I've not had such great teamwork. But anyway, stealth throws that flash, and in slow motion here, basically everyone who steps out is flashed from right here. But by the time they get unflashed, anybody who's distracted or flashed will still be distracted and flashed, while stealth and deranged charge forward. By this point, some enemies would have already caught on, but it doesn't matter so long as deranged is able to cover stealth's back. In this case, it's usually too late if there's no snipers watching. And so he makes it. This is just one of many examples of how it's done in a real tactical team, and I hope I can find more time to be able to witness the same as well as for staff members. And this is where things can get a little more interesting, because I'm following this guy, I'm following stealth, and it makes me see the fact that we can set up like a squad of four, and we can charge along with stealth into range to ensure that there's more safety. And all we need to do is kill the sniper window and defend some other positions to make this a successful mission. And that concludes this tutorial.